Welcome to a second example of determining the difference quotient for a given function. In this example, the given function is a quadratic function. And as mentioned in example one, this difference quotient, or this quotient here, is a very important quotient in the study of calculus. But for this example, we're just working on our algebra skills to simplify this quotient. So to start, we want to find f of the quantity x plus h, which means the quantity x plus h is the input into the given function. So wherever we see x, we'll replace x with the quantity x plus h. So if f of x equals x squared minus 3x plus 4, f of the quantity x plus h would be, instead of x squared, x plus h squared. And then instead of minus 3x, we'll have minus 3 times the quantity x plus h plus 4. So all of this is f of the quantity x plus h. Let's put this in parentheses to keep things clear. And now we still have to subtract f of x, so we'll have minus the quantity x squared minus 3x plus 4. All this is divided by h. Now we're going to multiply out f of the quantity x plus h, so we'll start by squaring the quantity x plus h. There's no shortcuts here. If we want to square the quantity x plus h, we'll have two factors of x plus h. When multiplying these binomials, we'll have four products, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So x times x is x squared. X times h is plus hx. H times x is another plus hx. And then finally plus h squared. So we'll have x squared plus, we have 1hx plus 1hx, that's 2hx, plus h squared, which means f of the quantity x plus h would be x squared plus 2hx plus h squared. And now we'll distribute negative 3, so we have minus 3x minus 3h plus 4. And we still have minus f of x, so minus the quantity x squared minus 3x plus 4. This is still divided by h. Now we'll clear the parentheses in the numerator and combine like terms. So if it's helpful, we can think of distributing a positive 1 here, which won't change anything. But because of the subtraction, we can think of distributing a negative 1 if that's helpful. For the first part, we would just have x squared plus 2hx plus h squared minus 3x minus 3h plus 4. Notice nothing changed. But for the second part, if we distribute negative 1 or subtract this entire function, it's going to change the sign of each term. So we'll have minus x squared. And then negative 1 times negative 3x is plus 3x. And then negative 1 times positive 4 would be minus 4. Now looking at the numerator, notice how we have x squared minus x squared, that's 0. We also have negative 3x plus 3x, that's 0. And then we also have 4 minus 4, that's 0. So we're left with 2hx. Plus h squared minus 3h divided by h. But we're not done yet. This does simplify further. Notice each term in the numerator contains a common factor of h. So we're going to factor out the common factor of h from the numerator. That will leave us with h times the quantity 2x plus h minus 3, still divided by h. But now we have h over h that simplifies to 1. So our simplified difference quotient is just 2x plus h minus 3. Okay, hope you found this helpful. Thank you for watching.